I'm Werner Vogels, the Chief Technology Officer of Amazon.com. I'm excited to welcome Bill Vaas, VP of Engineering at AWS, who's joining me to discuss how data movement capabilities have evolved over the years. Bill, thanks for joining us. If I think about that, there's multiple sides to storage engines. On one hand, that's what you store. The other hand is, how do you get it into the storage engine?
Yeah, so that's a great question, and thanks for having me. We always would prefer a customer to move data over a network if they have it available to them. And today you can have like DX connections of hundreds of gigs. And so we have a lot of products to make it easy to get the data in. Of course, you can load it directly into S3. We have Transfer, which for FTP and things like that. And we have Kinesis, which lets you string things in over the network for even things like cameras, for example. You can click this in. And so there's lots of cameras. This also works with LiDAR and things like that. And so those can be streamed in. And so the network's a great way to get it in. But a lot of our customers have way more data than they can send over the network. And so they came to us and said, I want to shut my data center down, or I've got this huge amount of data. I'm collecting the scientific data out in the field, or I'm doing movie shoots for you know, out in the field and things like that with 4K and now even 8K cameras. And so I need to move hundreds potentially of petabytes, and it would take years to do it over the network. And now we have a whole arranged array of products. And so we have like the smallest one, which I have here, which is a snow cone. But there's a lot on this behind the scenes. So the e-ink label is there so you can never put the wrong label on it, because we wouldn't want you to put your important data to the wrong place. So it knows where it's going, it labels itself. You might notice there's lots of anti-tamper on this, but there's also three layers of cryptography with three different keys, one of which isn't on the device, that encrypts the data three times with three different keys. And then we have its larger brother, which is the Snowball products, the Snowball Edge. And we were moving a lot of data centers, and a number of customers said, hey, you know, why can't you just send me a truck full of these at one time? And then that's where Snowmobile came from. So we've kind of done the evolution. But the interesting thing is, some people might think about this as, well, gee, that e-ink label is a gimmick, but it's actually a security feature. If you remember, you and I are both old enough to remember like loading things in with tapes and floppies, right? And you'd do a backup with 40 floppies, and then you'd get like halfway through and like, well, is this number 27 or number 28? So the Snowballs, you don't need to worry about that. They just know it and they just do it. And you don't need to worry about encryption. They just know it and they just do it. And so this is secure enough for the, you know, the intelligence agencies to use. It's secure enough for banks and healthcare and all those things. It meets HIPAA requirements and level 6+. So that's kind of, you know, the physical side of things. But the network side of things, we've invested a lot to make it easy to stream your data in and also accelerate your data over the network.
So, well, in the original Snowballs was purely a storage device.
Yeah.
These new devices or the new generations have compute on them as well.
Yeah.
From doing Lambda functions over to actually be able to run EC2 instances on them. So tell me why that evolution happened.
Yeah, so we had a lot of customers. A lot of data is collected in very rugged places. You know, a movie shoot is happening out in the middle of nowhere. We have drone operations, satellite ground station processing, oil rigs, scientific vessels, those kinds of things. And they're rugged locations. They can operate at, you know, minus 53 degrees and positive 140 degrees. So they can be handle 200 G impacts. You can even airdrop them with a parachute. They're rated for all that stuff.
So when we introduced a snowmobile at 2-3 years ago now at reInvent, with the big truck running in, tell me a bit, what kind of customers would use the snowmobile, the really massive storage?
Yeah, so great examples. The biggest use case is satellite customers right now. So they have these huge archives of imaging that are just, you know, hundreds of petabytes or thousands of, you know, exabytes kinds of data. And they're shutting their data centers down. They're shutting down their ground stations. And they want to move that data into long-term archive in Glacier and S3.
So yeah, so data movement is really important there. We've also done a number of things, including more moving things to the edge and having customers the ability to not necessarily have to go to the centralized place to upload data, but to make use of S3 acceleration, for example. Right. So tell us a bit about the thinking there.
Yeah, so we kind of look at what we call the three laws. So the law of physics, and that's a lot of what we're talking about here. You know, you just can't go faster than the speed of light. So if you need low latency local processing, things like wavelength and outpost and snowball and IoT and RoboMaker and Kinesis Fitting, all those things happen for you. If you have the law of economics, you might be able to move some of this data over a network, as I described. But if you have way too much data to move over the network, it just gets too expensive and takes too much time. And so you're kind of dealing with the two of the laws there. And then sometimes there's the law of the land, which is residency. So customers who want to load, like that's why we have S3 for outposts, so they can keep their data right there on the outpost if they need to.
Well, thanks, Bill. Thanks for talking to us here. The amazing thing is that sometimes people ask me, so are you ready to retire? And I go, what? No. Yeah. So I'm really looking forward to the next 15 years of engineering with you.
Yeah, me too. It's great talking to you.